If you love eating junk food and do not wish to get over with it, I would suggest you to stop watching this video right here. As in this video, I'm going to share with you some really disturbing facts about fast food giants, which unfortunately are unknown to a majority of people. The fast food industry is full of secrets, and in this video, I reveal each one of them to you. You will know how these popular fast food chains are fooling us in the name of natural flavors, ingredients, and whatnot. If you think natural means coming from plants and herbs, think again. From French fries and ice creams to chicken and chocolates, they all fall on the same page. So drop that packet of potato chips for a while, because you might hear something gross about them later in this video. Alright then, without any further delay, let's get started. Hello friends, welcome to FitTuber. The first food on the list, which is very gross, is ice cream. Do you like eating vanilla or strawberry ice cream? Are those your favorite flavors? Well, now you might want to stop buying them altogether. So, a basic ice cream is made by combining a mixture of cream, milk, sugar, and sometimes eggs. These ingredients are then frozen to create a delicious product. However, commercial ice creams also contain various stabilizers that make the product last longer. Till now, it sounds fine, but vanilla and strawberry ice creams also contain a specific flavor called castoreum. Well, you might ask, what's wrong with castoreum? Castoreum is secreted from a gland which is located near the anus of a beaver. Castor literally means a beaver. Castoreum is a chemical compound which is secreted by a beaver to mark its territory, just like dogs and various other animals. This secretion, when mixed with a little bit of beaver urine, smells exactly like vanilla. The use of castoreum is not only limited to ice creams, but also to various other vanilla flavoring products like perfumes, vanilla extracts, etc. So next time when you have that delicious scoop of vanilla ice cream, you better thank that beaver for its anal secretions. Beer. Beer is the third most consumed beverage in the world after tea and water. Next time you might want to think twice before opening that bottle of beer, because I just came across a very disturbing fact about it. Apart from alcohol, there is another ingredient which needs your attention, especially if you're a vegetarian. Beer has been in the market for over 7,000 years, but the way it is made has changed over time. The process of making modern beer is very simple. It starts by harvesting barley, which is then heated and dried. The grains are then mashed, boiled, and put in a fermenting vessel where the manufacturers add yeast, which make the beer fizz. Many factories add an ingredient called isinglass, which is obtained from a dried fish bladder. Yes, you heard that right, a fish bladder. Now the question is, why is it added? This is added only to make the beer look clearer. So you see, the element of fish is only there for aesthetics. Now I'm not saying that all the beer companies are using this ingredient, but you cannot be sure if the beer brand that you love uses it or not. Red candies. Candies are made by combining sugar, corn syrup, modified cornstarch, natural and artificial flavoring, coloring, dextrin, and so many other ingredients. But do you know where does that bright red color come from? It comes from an ingredient which is very disturbing. This terrible ingredient was also found in Starbucks strawberry frappuccino in 2012, which had caused a complete outrage. However, later Starbucks admitted that they had now stopped using it. It is called carmine, which is also known as the red food dye. And this so-called natural red food dye is made of crushed bugs. Yes, crushed bugs. Well, if you don't believe me, search for anything related to strawberry or raspberry flavors and check for carmine or natural red four or cochineal extract on the label. These terms refer to the dye extract from the cochineal bug. The cochineals are dried, crushed, and soaked in a mixture that gives us this bright red color for our foods. Just 1 pound of red dye requires about 70,000 bugs to produce. You will be surprised to find the number of things that include cochineal extract in its ingredients. Many red color foods in the restaurants, like juices, milkshakes, pastries, include these crushed bugs. Potato chips. When you are looking for something which is tasty and crunchy, you are most likely to reach for a packet of potato chips. Even though you do understand that the potato chips are not the healthiest foods to eat. Most likely you believe that they are just high in sodium, simple carbohydrates and fats, right? Wrong. Unfortunately, most brands of chips include a chemical compound called sodium bisulfite. Do you know where sodium bisulfite is used? It is used in antifungal products and facial cleansers. and now it is also found in potato chips. The question again arises, why is it added? Well, it turns out that this additive is very effective for preventing bacteria growth and it also stops potato chips from discoloring. Although food and health agencies state that it is okay to consume this chemical in a very small quantities, but they also say that this chemical should not be combined with meat, fruits or vegetables as it may react with these foods. On the other hand, the potato industry states that until a suitable substitute comes to light, not using sodium bisulfite would ruin their business. This is a perfect case of money versus health. Processed breads. We kind of understand that anything that is processed isn't great for our health. However, sometimes we don't really know what the food that we are eating actually contains. From fancy looking breads at the grocery stores to those deep fried apple and cherry pies, they all have some stuff in them which may be a source of concern for you. L-cysteine is a perfect example. L-cysteine is known as a dough conditioner. Although if you bake bread at home, there is absolutely no need to add it. But commercially, it is used to soften the dough so that the machines can better manipulate into things like cookies, breads and pies. But what's wrong with using L-cysteine? Well, it is the way it is made. L-cysteine is made through the process of hydrolysis with major ingredient being human hair. In places like China, it is sourced from hair sold by women. In North America, it is sourced from synthetic substances or feathers of ducks. L-cysteine has already been banned in European countries but not in United States of America or China, where it is still used in large quantities. So next time when you order apple pie from McDonald's, be aware that it has L-cysteine as a major ingredient. Chewing gum. According to archaeologists, humans are chewing gum for at least 5,000 to 9,000 years. However, the ingredients which were used to make the gum earlier and what we are using now are completely different. In early days, chewing gum used to be made from tree resins. The base of the gum was made of a natural substance called chicle, which is the sap of the sapodilla tree. Chicle was prominent for use in the production of chewing gum in the past. Today there are several brands of chewing gum, all competing with one another. Only a small number of brands are still using chicle as their gum base. Most modern gums are based on synthetic equivalent, a rubbery material called polyisobutylene, which is also used in the manufacture of inner tubes. Polyisobutylene is mixed with various food grade plasticizers and materials to make it chewable. Why this shift, you may ask? This is because synthetic rubber is much easier and cheaper to manufacture. Although it doesn't discard the fact that you are actually chewing rubber. Chicken nuggets and sausages. Do you know how chicken nuggets are made at your favorite restaurants like McDonald's, KFC, Domino's, Subway or any other popular food joint? The process is called mechanically separating chicken. The process starts by forcing the chicken into large machines on high pressure, which minces the chicken into puree. This includes all parts of the chicken like bones, eyes, beak, basically all parts that you might not want in your chicken nuggets. To make it worse, this paste is soaked with ammonia to kill any bacteria which may be present in the paste. Finally, the nuggets are artificially colored to get rid of that weird pink color. And have you ever wondered how do these sausages look so shiny? Those shiny casings on the sausages actually come from the animal intestines. It doesn't really end here. It is well known that these sausages are made from animal leftovers, from limbs to butts. So next time when you eat those chicken nuggets or hot dog, you can't really be sure if you're eating the breast part of the chicken or the butt part. McDonald's French fries. McDonald's French fries are as infamous as they are popular. Most of us order them as an add-on to our meals, thinking that they are just seasoned potato chips deep-fried in oil. Well, there is another ingredient in there which is difficult to pronounce as it is to digest. Dimethyl polysiloxane. Dimethyl polysiloxane is a chemical compound which is widely used in cosmetic products. It is also called siliputti or silicon oil. Well, what actually is the need to add this dangerous ingredient in the French fries? Not just French fries, but anything which is deep fried has dimethyl polysiloxane in it. It is used because it stops oil from foaming. Not only this, but also ammonium sulfate and TBHQ, which are used in fertilizer and petroleum industry respectively, are also added in McDonald's French fries. It is because of all these chemicals and substances that McDonald's French fries look visibly appealing even after weeks. You can just estimate how harmful they can be for your health. chocolates. Cadbury holds the chocolate market by selling over 350 million bars of dairy milk every year. Now you might be thinking, what am I going to say about your favorite chocolate? As it is obvious that these sweet tasting products are produced in busy crowded factories, there should be strict hygiene rules in places like these to keep everything in order. But still, you can imagine how difficult it would be to manage. Food Standards Agency is a governing body which monitors their factories for public safety. You will be shocked to know that their guidelines allow 1 rat hair per 100 grams of Cadbury chocolate. Yes, you heard that right. Cadbury's are legally allowed to serve you 1 rat hair per 100 grams of chocolate. So next time when you take a bite of that fruit and nut chocolate, you might want to think about what else is there too. And why just blame Cadbury? All chocolate brands would be following such norms. Soda fountain machines. How many times have you bought that bubbly Coke from a fountain machine to go with your favorite burger? Do you know that just one glass of cola has about 10 teaspoons of sugar in it? The sugar content is so high that the company has to add various chemicals to stabilize it, or else the human body would just puke it out. And when you drink cola from a soda machine, it is even worse for a bunch of reasons. Since the restaurant workers rarely clean the soda machines, there's most definitely a ton of mold on the pipes. The ice in such drinks have more bacteria than the water samples taken from the toilet bowls. Small insects and bad smell from these soda fountain machines is also very common. So do I need to tell you that please stop drinking cola from at least these fountain machines? So you see how these food giants are fooling us. Have you ever wondered why do we tend to go back to them again and again? If you think that it is only because they prepare delicious recipes, it is not entirely true. It is well known that they add a lot of addictive substances in the name of secret ingredients. Their motive is to make their business blossom without caring about public health. All they want to make is money, but it's our responsibility to be aware of what actually goes inside our body. I'm not asking you to stop eating junk food altogether. At least you can cut it down. Most importantly, make it a habit to go through the ingredients of whatever you buy so that you can choose the foods which are actually good for your body. And not all food products that you find at the supermarket are bad for you. There are some really good products also, like there is Pintola's All Natural Peanut Butter. Many of you have told me that you are unable to make homemade peanut butter because you are living in hostel or you do not have a food processor. To all of you, I would recommend Pintola's All Natural Peanut Butter. As I said, let us not go by the front label but the ingredients. And if you see, Pintola's All Natural Peanut Butter has only one ingredient, and that is roasted peanuts. So it has no hydrogenated oils, no added sugar, no preservatives, and absolutely no unwanted additives. So if your goal is to build muscle or to lose fat or just to live fit and fine, Pintola's All Natural Peanut Butter can be a part of your daily diet. You can try Pintola's smoothie recipe. All you would need is 250 ml of milk, 2 tablespoons of Pintola's All Natural Peanut Butter, 1/2 tablespoon of natural honey. Add these ingredients to a shaker and shake until smooth. Or you can also spread this peanut butter on a chapati and have it as a healthy snack option. You can buy this natural source of healthy fats by clicking on the link down in the description. So friends, I hope you found this video helpful. Well, if you did, please do give it a thumbs up. And also, please do remember to subscribe to my channel. My name is Vivek. I thank you so much for watching.